So hello everyone, welcome to the first FIFA 21 video on my channel. My name is Mark and in this video I'm going to show you the best controller and the best camera settings. The settings that I like to use the most, the setting that helps me a lot during the gameplay. First of all, I want to thank you very much for watching. Of course, please drop a like under the video if you think this video is useful, if it's helping you as well. And make sure you will subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss any other videos I'm posting. I'm doing tutorial videos, I'm doing tactic videos. So if you're interested in that, make sure you will hit that subscribe button. So we're going to start with the controller settings that I like to use. And the FIFA trainer is the first one. I'm showing you that I'm hiding that because I don't want the FIFA trainer in my screen because I'm playing FIFA already a few years, a lot of years, I can say. I'm playing FIFA from the first FIFA that came out, so I don't want the FIFA trainer. Then we're going to timed finishing. It's on. I'm not using it all the time, but when I have the time and when I think it's useful, I'm trying to use the timed finishing. I'm not doing that all the time. If it's very crowded, when it's a fast situation, you need to decide fast what you need to do. I'm only hitting the shooting button once, but when I have the time, I can time it. So that's why I'm using the timed finishing, and that's on. The next player switch indicator is on because it's useful to see what player you can switch to fast with the switch button. If you don't like to switch to that player but to another one, you can use your right stick. We're going to show you the settings for the right stick switching later, but for me this is on. Pass block assistant is off because sometimes the player, when you turn it on, sometimes the player is trying to block a pass or block a shot when you don't want to. And yeah, that's really frustrated because you can get out of possession really easy. And for me, that's not really good. So that's why I'm not using the assist for blocking passes. It's off for me. I'm deciding myself when I try to block it or when not. Auto switching on high balls is only air balls and loose balls. Then we're going to auto switching move assistance. I choose none. Jockey defending is assisted. You can also play it manual. I was playing it manual in FIFA 20, but in this FIFA there is a new dribbling mechanism, and yeah, it's really hard to defend when your opponent is really good at it. So I use assisted for now. Maybe when I get used to it, I'm switching it to manual, but for now, in the beginning of FIFA 21, I'm using assisted. Auto flare pass is off for me because it's a bit difficult to explain, but sometimes your player is doing a flare pass when you are using a really bad player. When you are playing with a 3-star or a 4-star team, you don't have really great players, and when they are not really good at passing and you have this on, they are passing really weird passes sometimes and you give the ball away really easy. So that's why I'm turning this off, because I want to decide myself when I want a good pass or not. So for me it's off. But when you are playing with only good players, with Barcelona, with Real Madrid, or when you are playing in Ultimate Team with really good players, maybe it's good to have it on. So the computer is deciding how to pass the ball to your other player. But for me, for now, it's off. Auto clearances is off. I had it on a few matches, but it gave me some horrible situations. When the AI is taking over, wanted to clear the ball away and it doesn't work at all. So your player is passing the ball or do nothing and you get a goal against really easy. So it's off. I'm deciding myself how I clear the ball. The AI doesn't have to do that for me. The same for auto shots. Sometimes you play, when you cross the ball, the AI is taking over and wanted to try a shot when you don't want to or something, and you waste a really good opportunity. I decide myself when I shoot or when I don't shoot. The same player lock, it's on. I'm not using that option a lot. I change it to off. You can change it to off, but for me it's on. The eagle dribbling, that's the new dribbling technique, the mechanism that I was talking about. It's on when you hold the R1 button, your player holds the ball really close. You can turn really quick left, right, so you really want to turn that on. It needs a little bit practicing to to control this dribbling, but when you're practicing it and when you get used to it, it's really, really good to use. So you need to turn that on and practice it a lot. Assisted headers is off. Oh, it gave me a horrible situation. I get a corner against and my player decided not to head the ball forward, so you can clear it out. No, he decided to head it back to my opponent and he scored the goal. So that was a really horrible situation. I turned this off. I am deciding when I'm heading the ball or not. Not the AI. Right stick switching that I was talking about. Ball relative, you can also choose it to player relative. This is really personal, but for me, ball related. So where the ball is, when the ball is in the center of your screen most of the times, you can switch players by using the right stick to flip the right stick to the left. You are switching to the player that is left of the ball, and when you're playing right, flip the stick right or up or down. You can also do it player relative. So when you are selected a player, that is the point that you need to flick to another player. But for me, ball relative is better. Then ground pass assistance is assisted for me. Through ball assistant is assisted. Shot assistant is assisted. And cross assistance is assisted. Lob pass also assisted. Save, that doesn't matter because I never play as a goalkeeper, but all is assisted for now. I used it to do it manual a few matches, and you can also choose semi, but it gave me a lot of horrible situations. I missed a lot of good shooting chances because it was manual, and even on semi I wasted a lot of shooting chances. Passing is really horrible when it was manual, so assisted is good for me. And even crossing, I really wasted a really good cross situation because it was on manual, and the ball ended up in the audience and not on the head of my striker. So all is assistant for now. That's worked the best for me. So the AI is helping you a bit when you are aiming to a player, when you don't aim really secure. It will help you a bit so you don't waste a lot of chances and passes. Analog sprint is off, because if you are turning it on and you don't pull the trigger to the max, then your player isn't running as fast as he can. So for me, I always want my players, when I'm sprinting, I want them to sprint the max and not halfway. So if you are not holding the trigger to the max, your player is not running to the max, and that's not what you want. You want your players to run as fast as possible, and then when you don't want to sprint, you don't touch the sprint button. So that's why it's off for me. Tactical defending is on. Pass receiver lock is late, because when you are passing and on the latest moment you decided to switch to pass to another player because your opponent is switching sides or something, you can switch even when you already are pressing the pause button. If you are doing it too early, there is no chance you can switch to another player, and sometimes it's really frustrated. So for me, this is on late. Then we're going to the game settings, and I'm going to show you my camera settings, because I get a lot of questions all the time, what camera are you using? So here it is. I'm using telebroadcast, even on single player, and on multiplayer, both the same. And the other thing that I am changing here, you need to switch camera settings to custom. It's on default, but you need to switch to custom. Camera height is the max height on 20. Camera zoom is minimum to 0. So this is for me the best camera setting. You get max overview on the field, and for me personal, this is the best camera setting. So this is it. This was the tutorial about the controller settings and the camera settings. I hope it's useful for you, and hopefully it will help you to play better matches. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.